Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are having a wonderful and amazing day just like me. And today I'm going to be showing you how to make cutscenes in Roblox Studio. Now, the reason why I'm making this video is because I have seen a bunch of cutscene videos and most of them are outdated, so I'm going to go ahead and give you an up-to-date version. So yeah, let's just go ahead and get right on into this. And also, please be sure to leave a like and subscribe on the channel. And go ahead and join the Discord server. It's called the Hangout Area. The link to it will be in the description. So yeah, now let's just get into this video. So we're gonna go ahead and go into replicated storage. We're gonna add in a remote event. This remote event is gonna be cutscene. So let's just go ahead and name it that. Make sure it has a capital C as well. And then we're gonna go ahead and go into server script service. We're gonna add in a new script. And we're gonna go ahead and say game.players.playerAdded colon connect function and then PLR right there. So we have the player as our argument. Now we're gonna go ahead and put in a weight. Now the reason why I'm putting in this weight is because usually whenever we're dealing with cutscenes, we have to change the camera to like go to another thing, like a part, obviously. And the problem with that is that sometimes whenever that happens, saying that like for like I don't know why this error happens, it's just weird. But anyway, so what we're gonna do is in this wait, we're just gonna wait 1.5 seconds. It will even seem like that there's like it's not even waiting once we actually load in the game. And then we're gonna go ahead and do game.replicatedStorage.cutscene. Cutscene colon fire client, and then put in our player argument in here. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and in starter player scripts, we're gonna add in a new local script. And what we're gonna do here is we're gonna go and make a variable for the Roblox tween service. So we're gonna name this variable tween service equals game colon get service. So the tween service is kind of like Roblox's animation service. So yeah, that's basically what the tween service is. Now we're gonna go ahead and create a function. And this function is gonna, And then this function is gonna be called cutscene. Now we're gonna go ahead and add in four arguments to this cutscene. We're gonna add in the first argument, which is camera one, which is the camera that we're gonna be starting on. Next is camera two, which is like how we're gonna animate our cutscene. And then next is seconds to wait until fire. So this is how many seconds we're gonna wait until we actually fire this cutscene. And then next we're gonna add in our last, which is seconds to wait. Now on this variable right here, you'll be able to see like what it is on the way, like it's gonna be how long the animation is from the first camera to the second camera. That's basically what it is. So now we're gonna go ahead and put in a wait, and this wait is gonna be for the seconds to wait until we actually fire this function. Now we're gonna go ahead and make sure that the camera is set to camera one. And how we do that? Well, we do game.workspace.currentCamera.cframe equals camera one dot cframe. So now that we know that it is set to camera one, we're gonna go ahead and add in a variable for the tween info, So we're gonna do local info equals tween info dot new. And we'll just do enter. And then here we're gonna type in seconds to wait. And then enum dot easing style dot is it not? Oh yeah, liner. Or I think that's how you say it. I'm not really sure how you say it. Now we're gonna do enum dot easing style dot not dot easing style, easing direction. I'm sorry. In out. Then we're gonna do a comma, and then we're gonna do zero because we're not gonna repeat this like again. And then false, just so it doesn't reverse on us. And then zero. So yeah, and also if you want to reverse it, just put in a new, like I'll show you how to reverse it when you want. Just make sure that this is set to false, or else it's gonna reverse all your cutscenes. So now that we did that, we're gonna add in a another variable, and this one is gonna be local tween equals tween service colon create. So this will create our animation or our tween, and we'll do game dot workspace dot current camera, because that's what we're gonna be animating or tweening, whatever you want, comma info, comma, and then we're gonna put in a table. And what this table is, we're gonna add in a value called cframe, and then that is going, cframe, and then that is going to be equal to camera 2 dot cframe. Okay, now that we have that, we're going to go ahead and do tween colon play, so it will play our animation. Next, we're going to add in a return, because this is going to, this function is going to return something. And what that's going to return is, this is going to wait until the cutscene is done. We're going to type in just seconds away. So basically what this does is, when we fire this function, this is going to wait until it goes to the next line after the function. So let's go ahead and just put in our function right now. So we'll do game dot replicated storage dot cutscene dot on client event colon connect function, and then we're going to put that. So now, because we don't have any arguments, we're not going to do anything. But now we're going to go ahead and do game dot workspace dot current camera dot camera type equals enum dot camera type dot, it's a dot scriptable, just so we can actually, now that we have done that, we're gonna go ahead and add in our cameras into the workspace. So how do we do that? Well, as you can see, there is already a camera right here, but this isn't the camera that we're gonna be adding. We're just gonna be adding in parts for our cameras. So we're gonna go and add in a part. Now we're gonna go ahead and name this part camera one. Now we're gonna go and run a command on the command line. Now, how do you get this command line? Well, we're gonna go ahead and go into view, and then make sure that command bar is selected. And then just find your command line. I put mine up here, yours may be down here. So yeah, just so you know. And also make sure that you have your output open. It's gonna look like this. Just click on the output here, make sure it's selected. And yeah. Now we're gonna run a command here, and this is gonna be game dot workspace dot camera one dot what was it? Yeah, front surface equals enum dot surface type dot not dot smooth dot motor, and then we're just gonna click enter. So, the reason why we added this here is because this is the way that our camera is going to be facing. So, because the motor's right here, because, like, that's where the front surface is, it's going to be facing this way. So, we're going to go ahead and just anchor this as well, just so it doesn't, like, fall out of the sky if you're going to be having them in the sky or whatever. I recommend just anchoring them, like, just in the first place. So, I'm just going to go and scale down the camera a little bit. And also just pull it back. And then we're going to go and move this up. Just like that. And then I'm going to rotate it as well. And also, if yours isn't as smooth as this, what you can do is you can go into model and uncheck both of these. Make sure that they're both unchecked like that. And then we're going to rotate this down a little bit. So this angles more towards the ground. And then, actually, before we keep going, we're going to go ahead and add in just a new part. I'm going to, you definitely don't have to. I'm just adding this as if for, like, a, whatever you call it. Like a, I just can't think. So, yeah, this is just for, like, design. Sorry, that's the word that I was thinking of. So, now we're going to go ahead and I'm going to duplicate this camera. And I'm just going to do Control D to duplicate it. And then I'm going to name it Camera 2. Now, you can obviously just do Camera 3, Camera 4, and all that. So, now I'm going to move my second camera and rotate it and stuff. Now, again, you can put your cameras wherever you want. I'm just doing these cameras right here for examples. And I'll actually go and use this one. So yeah, I'm just doing these cameras as examples. You can add in as many cameras as you want, just as long as you name them about something like camera one, camera two. As long as you name your cameras something around these lines. Now, and also, they cannot have duplicate names or else, it will glitch. So, yeah, make sure that it's, like, camera 1, camera 2, camera 3, camera 4, and not two camera 1s and two camera 2s. So, yeah. Now, we're going to go ahead and, in our local script, I'm going to go ahead and add in our first camera for, I can't speak. I'm sorry. Just do game.workspace dot dot current camera dot C frame equals game dot workspace dot camera one dot C frame. Now, make sure to add this line for the first camera that you want to start it off as. Now, if you want to start off their first camera at the player, like as the player, like, you know, how when you're just like walking around, like if you want to keep it there, then do not add in this line. But if you don't, like if you want to start off as like a certain camera, then add in this line and make sure that you put in the part as like the C frame. Just make sure that this right here is the name of the part. Now, we're going to go ahead and run our function. So we're going to do cutscene, and then we're going to put in our first camera, and that camera is going to be our So game dot workspace dot camera one dot C frame. And then we're gonna add in camera two. And then, oh, and also, you do not need to add in this line right here, I don't think. Yeah, no, we don't. Not right now. So, oh, and also, don't add in this dot C frame. So, what you need to do is, like, if you're actually starting off as the player, for your first camera, do game.workspace.currentCamera, and just make sure that's that if you want to start off as, like, the camera at the player. So, but I'm not going to be doing that, so I'm going to make sure that it starts off at camera one. Next, we're going to go to our second camera, because like that's where it's going to be moving to. So we're going to do game dot workspace dot camera two, and then seconds to wait. I'll go ahead and wait 2 seconds before it starts moving to our second camera. You do need that other line if you're gonna like wait until you move to your next camera. You know what? No, I'm just not gonna add in a wait for that, but you can if you want. Like, I'll show you what I'm gonna do. So I'm just gonna make this 0 seconds because we're not gonna wait. And then we're gonna go ahead and put in our seconds to like wait. And I'm gonna make that 3 seconds. So now that we did that, we're gonna go ahead and click on play. And then let's go and wait. And as you can see, so that's not good. But as you can see, it did definitely kinda move. But there was an error there, so it did glitch out a little bit. Sometimes an error is there. The more the wait here, the like less likely that you're gonna get that error. I don't know why that error happens. Okay, so as you can see, now we did this successfully. So yeah. Oh, and also these two, dev camera computer movement mode, or dev computer camera movement mode, and dev touch.